from my opinion, the best way for Cannon to win this matchup is to do some really, really unexpected edge guards on this.
Yeah, honestly, the forward air or even a up air.
The reverse up air.
Yeah, with a good angle. Yeah. But if he picks something like Rylat, he's not gonna have that option because you can't risk that as Ganon. Because like if you miss, like that's it, you know.
And it's so hard. You're dead.
Yeah, if it tilts, you're dead. Honestly, like doesn't matter how good you are at the map, like you're gonna struggle. That's some good damage, but I think he might be behind. It's always hurt his mouth since he's so big. What I like to do in that situation is if I know that a Ness or a Lucas is going to try to jump above the map, I'll throw a Dark Smash at a distance. If it doesn't hit them, it'll give me other options, you know? Ooh. He's just keeping them spaced out. He can't even get in at all. Oh. Oh, was that a tech? I didn't see.
He covered himself with the PK Thunder, right?
It was weird because I didn't see a tech, but he didn't die. So it had to be a tech, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Ooh. Okay, that was good, but that's gonna. Wow. Okay, good DI, good DI. That tilt's gonna be nice. Going for the horse match. He wants to close it out. But tilt's kill too. Especially someone small like Ness. That'll kill him. Forward air, forward air. Ooh. He threw out the forward air, so that took away the option for him to throw it.
And double taunt.
Ooh.
Oh! To show off his dominance out here.
Show off his dominance. That is going to backfire hard. Alright. That's down tilt. Yeah, because if you know they're not going to tag as Ganon, they're going to want to down tilt. Ooh. Wow, they're actually playing really good against each other.
I know that unfortunately Ganon can't follow up the tilt off of the side B grab. Honestly, he's so skinny.
Yeah.
Damn, that must be rough.
Yeah, honestly, if you main Ganon you have to fight Sheik, it's... there's not much I can say about it.
But Ness over here is a mini Sheik throwing out fairies.
Yeah.
Carrying Ganon off stage.
That was a really good option. If the percentage gets a little higher, dash attack might kill.
At around 1%.
I want to say like 120. Like if he was at 120 and needed a dash attack.
And then not including rage?
No, that's accounting for rage. It's not just 120 it kills, because that'd be ridiculous. But you see how
Damn. Edge guard.
That's how he's gonna win. If he wants to win, he's gonna need the edge guards. Okay. Survival. They're watching the replay on the TV. He's gonna ban Battlefield? Gosh, you know what? It's weird, but no. I was gonna say I think Link does better, or does worse against Ness than Ganon, but no. I was just thinking, because he has like the projectiles to keep Ness at a distance, as opposed to Ganon, who literally just has to brawl it up. But Ganon gets fast kills, so no. But I did. Three, two, one, go! And okay, so this is definitely one of Ness's more dominant stages because of Wispy. So if we get him caught in the fire and Wispy's just blowing on him, that's gonna cause some problems. Good spacing. Oh. Damn, he was waiting for the neutral get up. It's a good read, it's just that it's not likely to happen.
Alright, good punish.
He had the PK Thunder out. That would have been it. He had the PK Thunder out, so that might have possibly weirdly extended it for box, but I'm not sure about that. Oh, he's trying to really wrap this up.
He is.
What he should have done was jump off the map again so he could decide B if he gets. Oh my goodness. Absolute dominance. Might get edge guarded right now. No. He shouldn't have given up safe position. That was a good job though. Oh, I was gonna say up smash, but this isn't really good. Just kidding. Okay, so if it would have hit him at a certain angle, he might have been able to check it.
DI into the stage.
Yeah, DI into the stage. Yeah. Check it. Yeah,
that's the best thing when you get off stage. DI into the stage and try to check.
Yeah.
If you have 0%.
Oh, wow.
That might be it.
Oh. He gave up a stage positioning.
Oh.
Didn't get all the forward.
Let's get to convert this into. There you go.
Yeah. I'm just going at it. Usually I have like a prediction of who's gonna win, but I don't even know right now, to be honest. He's not tagging it. He just needs a down tilt. The down tilt would have killed him, man. But he was still able to get it. So. Switch forever.
Ooh, confident in Ganon.
I can respect that. Honestly, sometimes I'll be playing an actual bracket and I'll be using like Link and I'm just like, I'm not feeling it. Ganon.
Three, two, one, go!
It's funny, me and him made the same character.
Nope. I haven't seen Ganon do this, so I'm not gonna try to save that up. But I really, really wanna see Ganon edge guarding the up facing Howard.
Oh yeah, yeah, Howard
just
good. It's harder to hit. Oh my goodness. It's harder to hit. Because like if you're Captain Falcon, it feels like an instant move, but for Ganon it's very questionable. Oh, that was his fall overextending.
He really, really needed that.
Yeah. Taunting in his invulnerability frames. That's not gonna save him from forward air, though. They're just getting flashy on each other. This is actually a friendly bench. Actually a friendly bench. He's missing a side beat. He's getting good hits in, but I think Baxi might be getting a little irritated. Oh, yeah, throwing out some questionable options.
Alright.
Oh, that was good, but he was able to shield it. Yeah, I haven't seen him extend a side beat.
That I feel like that's really important as Ganon.
Oh, it is.
That's
free damage.
Yeah.
It's free damage to extend.
That's the biggest combo he could do.
Yeah. It's crazy because in Project M, you could do it like 3 times in a row really fast. Oh my gosh. Oh no. Okay, good. I get it. Okay. He earned that. What's it called? The green orb? What's it called?
Side magnet? Or
the green
PK thing flash?
Explodes?
The PK
yeah.
flash?
Okay, the PK flash. If that had killed him, I would have been like, oh man, that's too obvious, you know? But he got killed with an upper, that's fair. So.
Survival!
Okay. No switches here, I don't think. He's confident in Ganon. And Baxi's confident in that, so we'll see how this goes. Okay, he banned Lilat, which is good, because I think they both suffer on that stage. So no one's benefited from that.
I feel like this is Ganon's best stage, though.
It is, and the reason it is because you have maps where, you know how Smashville, how the platforms will drift off?
Yeah.
People can drop off of those platforms and edge guard them. And that's a huge problem because the recovery is kind of bad.
Yeah.
So, on this map, the platform stumbles off. So, you know, he's basically, his toolkit isn't threatened, you know? I think it's for...
And the platforms give Ganon pretty good coverage.
Yes, for up airs.
Oh, I mean, it'll give anyone pretty good coverage, but...
Yeah. But for him, he gets a free up air, free up smashes for the two platforms towards the bottom. Ooh. Good air dodge. That might have been fatal if he hadn't.
good up there.
Oh, down B. He's landing with it a lot, but he's actually hitting it. So, I mean, if it's not broken, he'll fix it. So, oh. He's waiting for more patient options now. He's not just going for forward airs. He's trying to see what he can do off of that. That might be nice.
Yeah.
Oh, well, it's dead. Because really? He's not going to recover. Wait, Magna Hands. Oh, almost shield break. Oh my gosh, he's actually going crazy.
For the tech. He should have tried to tech.
He got too scared. He probably wasn't confident in his ability to tech, but you know, it's worth a try. It's worth a try.
Yeah, honestly, yeah. At that point, he was already forgetting to get back to him.
Yeah.
So, the risk was worth it.
Yeah. Oh, he's throwing out too many hitboxes. He got hit with his second hitter down smash. That's okay, though. He's still in it. Get some forward airs, get some damage. See what he can do off that.
He just shut him up.
Yeah.
He was like, he can...
Oh, beautiful up smash.
He kicked him right in the jaw, man.
Yeah, right in the jaw.